Would come by every day and look in the windows, waiting for us to get open. So we finally got open, and Norm and Cynthia came in, and Norm came and talked to Josh first. Josh was in, my son Josh was in there. Josh came over to me and he said, you need to go talk to this gentleman over here. He's an English gentleman, and you need to go talk to him. Or he wants to talk to me. He said, Norm wanted to talk to me. So I went over and introduced myself, and Norm told me who he was, and he asked me for a job. He said, I said, what? I mean, we'd only been open like an hour, you know. And he said, I'd like to work for you, in his accent, you know. I said, well, I appreciate you asking and all, but I'm not real sure what we would have you do. And he looked at me strange and he said, well, I could dust and make the tea.
Thank you. people in Manchester really hate each other. They're about 30 miles apart, and for about 200 years we've hated each other. Anyway, we got talking, and right from that moment we really hit it off. And he came together with Cynthia for a long time. In fact, we ate in here with myself, Rebecca, Norman, Cynthia at this table right here a couple of years ago. And we became great friends, the four of us. And of course, this last year or so, Norm's been coming on his own, and he would come into the restaurant, and he'd try and sometimes do his best to come at a quiet time of the day, but the girls would, like, the waitresses would roll their eyes, think, oh, they killed Rebecca would be in the kitchen, and they'd go to Rebecca and say, Rebecca, can you come out to the front, please? And she said, where's Philip? She goes, oh, English Norman's in, and he's sitting down having his lunch with English Norman, so there's nobody to work the register. we'd be in there for about an hour and a half talking about all kinds of things, solving all world problems, talking about music, talking about football, and talking about England and families and stuff, and it was great, you know, really quality time. But the girls used to think, oh no, Norman's come in, because that means Philip's going to be the castmates, so they had to call Rebecca out to the kitchen. Anyway, but that was great, and then Norman, as I say, Norman was just like he is to all of us here. Great friend, great guy, and somebody you can't help but like, even though he's from Manchester. Okay, earlier on I sent a little, I'm on Facebook with Kate, his daughter, so I sent her a little text and a photograph of what we were doing.
Can you say that in English?
You start over from Norm used to come in.
Yeah.
If you'll just throw in a well placed y'all every once in a while.
That's
all we need.
Anyway,
I make a cheat sheet.
Thank you. I sent his daughter a little text earlier on, a message just saying, hey, we're at Cruisers, of course, she knew. Celebrating her dad and his mum's life, you know, with a lot of friends here, and you know, with a lot of people telling great stories. You all playing great music. Some of Norm's great, some of his favourite things. Of course, I come from Liverpool. I've put Beatles in there. Playing a lot of Beatles, which is great. Thank you. Anyway, she wrote back to me, and even though it's like 1 o'clock in the morning over there, and she says, "Wow, I'm so touched." That's you. Please tell everyone how grateful we are for the love and friendship you all have shared with Dad. She said, I used to hate it when he used to go away and we missed him like crazy, but seeing how happy he was and how happy we all here made him was very special and meant a lot of quality time over here for both of them. My dad would be shouting, play some Kinks. The support we've received from you guys has been so important, and I know each time I read the messages from you to my dad, the biggest smile appeared despite the pain that he was going through. I'm sure he would tell me to remind you how much he loved you all. I hope you manage to have a few laughs and a few great memories. Lots of love, Kate.
Yeah. Is everybody ready now? Yeah, we're here.